أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد مفتاح باب رحمة الله عدد ما في علم الله صلاة وسلاما دائمين بدوام ملك الله وعلى آله وصحبه عدد كل ذرة ألف مرة اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها أما بعد فأحييكم بتحية الإسلام السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته Verily a greeting which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned in a hadith لا تدخل الجنة حتى تؤمنوا that a person will not enter Jannah until he has attained Iman, until he has attained true faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى تَحَابُوا And a person will not be able to attain this true faith or this true Iman until he loves his brother for the sake of Allah. And our beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given us the instruction or the alternative. أَوَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمُوهُ تَحَابَبْتُمْ Shall I indicate to you such an action or such a deed that if you do it, you will love each other for the sake of Allah. Because without loving our brothers, without having this true mahabbah, we will not be able to attain the trueness or the sweetness of Iman. And without us attaining this true sweetness or this kamil of Iman, this completeness of Iman, we will not be able to attain Jannah. And by a simple action which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given us, أَفْشُ السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ to spread the salam amongst one another. For indeed, Jama'atul Muslimin, the salam brings love. The salam breaks the barriers of hatred between brothers. If I, for instance, have a tiff with my brother, just by me taking my hand out and greeting him, Assalamu alaikum, it somehow erases that fire between us. Even though we feel a bit hesitant in order to take my brother's hand, but I take it for the sake of the salam. And verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructs us in the Quran, وَإِذَا حُيِّيتُم بِتَحِيَّةٍ فَحَيُّوا بِأَحْسَنَ مِنْهَا أَوْ رُدُّهَا That if you greet, or if you have been given the salam, or if you're greeting, وَإِذَا حُيِّيتُم بِتَحِيَّةٍ السلام, the tahiyya is السلام عليكم. فَإِذَا حُيِّيتُم بِتَحِيَّةٍ فَحَيُّوا بِأَحْسَنَ مِنْهَا أَوْ رُدُّهَا Then greet it or reply to that salam, that tahiyya with a better greeting. And this is the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And really, when we have the salam between us, this peace, this tranquility between brotherhood or between brothers, then surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts a heart that is free from hatred towards his brother. A heart that is free from any envy or jealousy, should we say, or any hatred or malice towards his brother. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Qaf, مَنْ خَشِيَ الرَّحْمَنَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَجَاءَ بِقَلْبٍ مُنِيبٍ Whoever fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the unseen, when no one sees him. When no one sees him, he is tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he fears Allah. وَجَاءَ بِقَلْبٍ مُنِيبٍ, and he comes to Allah with a pure heart. A heart that is free from any hatred. A heart that is free from any jealousy towards his brothers. That heart Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts in his court. And when we are in the divine court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which each and every one of us will meet him subhanahu wa ta'ala, that meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to us, when he sees that our hearts are free from these defects or these sicknesses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to us, Udkhuluha bisalam. Enter Jannah with peace, the same salam that we greet one another with. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enter us into the paradise with a salam. Dhalika yawmul khulud, that day will be forever. That day will be forever. And may it be inshaAllah ta'ala that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as we meet and we come for the love of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to follow his sunnah, and for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to follow his commandments, and for the love that we meet one another, that we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enter us all into Jannah with the same salam, udkhuluha bisalam, dhalika yawmul khulud. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we thank and we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the opportunity once again to witness a blessed day as the day of Jumuah, and that we are indeed in this blessed month of Rabi'ul Awwal, the month in which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. And for this, we find that how many of us are following the sunnah or the teachings of this beloved man salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to us as a rahmatun lil alameen, as a mercy unto mankind. How many of us embody his character salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, who made Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had looked at the entire character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he has affirmed it in the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, that verily, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are on the highest pinnacle of character. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, that if you want to look at good character, good morals, if you want to look at how to be as a neighbor, we look at the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you want to look at how to be as a father, then you look at the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you want to look at a person whom was a community leader, then you look at the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For really Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ, that in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a perfect example. In Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is a true and a perfect example. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had also warned the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it is a warning for all of us, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ, if it were not for the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah had made the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam soft and gentle, وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْ فَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, If you are a harsh-hearted person, if you are a harsh-hearted person, a person that did not have a way to speak to people, then people would never have followed you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the testament that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave our Prophet Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And therefore, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given us in a clear hadith that we all know, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِيُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. I was sent to this earth, or I was created to perfect good character. To perfect good character. To show us as the Ummah, to show mankind what an example of good character is. And if we look in the lifestyle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we find this. Definitely. So you find, my dear brothers and sisters, elders and youth, that many a times the khutbah that we talk about, the lectures and the sermons that we give, is always about good character and conduct and how to address people. But yet we find the Ummah lacking in these models. So therefore, we find it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That verily a reminder is good for a believer. That we constantly remind ourselves. We constantly remind ourselves about how to conduct ourselves towards our neighbors. Conduct ourselves towards our wives. How to conduct ourselves towards our husbands. How to conduct ourselves with our colleagues at work. Every aspect of our life, whether it is personal or whether it is in our professional life. And therefore, inshallah ta'ala, we will highlight some blessings in today's talk about the blessings which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has reminded us. Firstly, for myself, has reminded us about the many blessings. And I will just extract some blessings from the lifestyle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and some ayat that were mentioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. And we find that is the nature of a Muslim. A nature of mankind is that if they know the blessings of something, they will be more eager in doing something like this. They will be more eager in doing that action. That is the nature of a person. That if he sees the blessing or he realizes the blessing in something, he will be more eager in doing this action. So we remind ourselves that one of the blessings that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in many ahadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reminds the companions, ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, whenever he would give them a reminder, he would always remind them of good morals or good character, how to conduct themselves. And one of the companions that came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said to them, and he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Prophet of Allah, give me some advice. Awsini, give me some advice. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reminded him and he said to him, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, said to him, La tarda, do not become angry. And the man looked at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahabi, he looked at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he thought, oh Prophet, I think the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is shortchanging me somewhere. Such as just two words. He thought the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is going to give him a big sermon. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam just told him, La taghdab, And then he asked the Prophet again, O Prophet of Allah, give me more advice. And the Prophet ﷺ told him, La taghdab, do not become angry. And he asked again for the third time, and the Prophet ﷺ said to him, La taghdab. In another hadith, when Mu'adh was set off for Yemen, Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, when he was set off for Yemen, the Prophet ﷺ, some of the ulama say that this was the last part of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sermon to Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him advice and he said to him, Ittaqullah haythu ma kunt. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you are. Fear Allah wherever you find yourself. Wherever you find yourself in this world, fear Allah. Have the conscience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart. It was the first of the last part of the sermon of to Mu'adh ibn Jabal. And then he said to him, وَأَتْبِعِ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُوهَا سَيَّأَتَهَا تَمْحُوهَا. That follow a bad deed, or when you do a bad deed, follow it by something that is good, خَيْر. A hasana, something that is good. That if you had made a mistake or a sin, then by that good deed that you have done after that bad deed, this is a mercy by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That good deed that you have done will erase that small, that will erase that bad deed. This is the mercy and the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell him after this? وَخَالِقِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. And when you meet people, oh Mu'adh, when you meet people, when you interact with people, interact with them with goodness and kindness and good character. Oh Mu'adh, when you meet with good people, when you meet with people, meet with them with good character. Do not display anger or bad ill manners towards people. Always show them good character. In another hadith, a companion came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, اجتنبوا الكبائر. Stay away from major sins. Stay away from major sins. And overlook the faults of others. This is part of good character, of good manners. If someone had done you something wrong, overlook it. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحْ فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Whoever pardons, whoever forgives, his reward is immense by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His reward and his reward will be great by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one who shows afu. He does not just forgive. He does not just forgive, but he erases it. He wipes it out of his mind. He doesn't think about it. He doesn't mention it again. This is the quality of afu. وَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحْ. He reconciles. فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. His reward by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is immense. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the reward of that person. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the reward of this person. So we can see in the first hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to the companion, La taghdab. In the second hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when you meet someone, or when you meet the people, meet them or interact with them with good character. In the third hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, forgive and pardon people. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, another blessing from the Prophet salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. That people cannot be given any blessing better. A people cannot be given any blessing better than one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed him with good character. No one has been given a better blessing by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than one whom Allah has given someone good character. Subhanallah. How many a times do we see people who have wealth and are affluent in our communities, but they judgmental, or they put people down, or they have bad character, and people despise them. And by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will find people that do not even have money, but they are kind and gentle and have good character, but they are loved by the communities. They are loved by the communities. This is whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi speaks about. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, he says to his companions, عَلَيْكَ بِحُسْنِ الْخُلُقِ, upon you, O my companions, is good character. He's commanding them. And then he says, and follow that by long periods of silence. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, by the one whom my soul rests, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not beautified anything better than by these two qualities. مَا تَجَمَّلَ الْخَلَائِكُ بِمِثْلِهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not beautified creation better than with these two qualities. By a person having good quality, good character, good manners, and a person being silent, a person being quiet for long periods of time. Because the more a person speaks, the more he gets himself in trouble. The more he speaks, the more he will get himself in trouble. So this was the quality of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that he would always try and keep his silence for long periods. For the poet says, Sun lisanak, protect your tongue. فَإِذَا سُنْتَ صَانَكْ, if you protect your tongue, it will protect you. فَإِذَا خُنْتَ خَانَكْ, and if you deceive this tongue, it will deceive you. For Shaykh Ramadan al-Buti, he mentions in one of his kitabs, in one of his kutub, he mentions that إِنَّ الْكَلَامَ لَفِي الْفُؤَادِ, that very speech is in the heart, very speech is in the heart. وَإِنَّمَا جُعِلَ اللِّسَانُ عَلَى الْفُؤَادِ دَلِيلًا, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the tongue a proof for what is in the heart. And just by you seeing someone talking, and the things that he is talking about, you will understand the condition of that person's heart. Another blessing of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we know most of us, somehow in our lives we shortchanging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, by our ibadah, how we perform our ibadah. Are we performing our ibadah the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really wants us to perform it? No. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave us a chance. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned that a person can come on the level. He can reach the level of a person who is sawam qawam, a person who fasts continuously. And we know the reward by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about a person that fasts. Qawam is a person that stands up for tahajjud very often. And we know the reward of a person that stands for tahajjud. He says, even though our basic ibadah is in place, but we're not like those people. We're not like those people. But we can reach that level. How? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, بِحُسْنِ خُلُقِهِ, by his good character. By him having good character towards people, towards himself, towards his family, that person, he can reach the level of a person that is sawam qawam, Another blessing of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentions that the sign of a person's Iman, to know the level of the person's Iman, is known by his character, by his manners. For Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentions in a hadith, أَكْمَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِيمَانًا أَحْسَنُهُمْ خُلُقًا. The most perfect of believers in Iman, the one who has the most kamil Iman, the most complete Iman, is the one who is the best in character. Subhanallah. The one who has the most perfect Iman, he is the one who has the best character. أَحْسَنُهُمْ خُلُقًا. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he summarizes what Iman, good character, and Iman, how it correlates to one another. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in two words, Ad-deenu al-mu'amala. That deen, religion, is based on your interaction with one another. Your deen, your religion, is based on your interaction with one another. How you are with people, that is the level of your religion, that is the level of your Iman, and that is how you are judged. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he describes these people. He says to them, what are the description of these people who have good character? يَأْلَفُونَ وَيُؤْلَفُونَ. They are friendly natured people. They love to be friendly with people, and they allow people to be friendly with them. It's not like I come to my home, I come in my house, quah, angry, pass me tea. No, that type of thing. Where's the tea? Shouting the wife, shouting the children. No, that is not the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he comes home, he leaves everything that he has done the day that there was. Maybe he had a bad day at work, or someone had made him angry. No, he does not come with that home. He comes to his home. He's come to his home, treats his children with friendliness, with kindness. And he loves people to be friendly with him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the character also of a person that has good manners, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ. And the ibad, the slaves of Ar-Rahman, the slaves of Ar-Rahman, the slaves of the Most Merciful, الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنَا. They are those people who walk on the earth, they walk in this dunya, humble, kind, in nature. And then what is it also? وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. When an ignorant person comes to him, when an ignorant person comes to him, a person that is ill-mannered, that treats him bad, he comes to him, he addresses him. What does he say? Salama. He interacts with peace in that man, he interacts with peace. In that instant, he interacts with peace, with good manners towards him. This is good character that Rasulullah and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about. And a mu'min is also a person which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes in a hadith, hayyinun layyin. He's a person that is soft, kind, and gentle towards people. And then another characteristic, inshallah, we will end off. Inshallah, which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, inna allaha jameel, yuhibbul jamal. Allah is beautiful. Allah is beauty, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves beauty. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, inna Allah jameel yuhibbul jamal. Allah loves beauty. Wa yuhibbu makarim al-akhlaq. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves beautiful character. Allah loves good manners. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, should I not tell you of a person that Jannah has become haram for? that Jannah has become haram for that person. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Sahaba asked, who are these people, O Prophet of Allah? The Prophet of Allah says, it is a person with a harsh tongue. A person that has a harsh tongue, whenever you come in his company, you want to move away from his company. Because you know the things that are coming out of his mouth. Bali is filth. It is foul language. It is talking about someone all the time. And then, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who embody good character. Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. And then the last one, which I will end off with this, which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, that we all wish and we yearn for this. On the day of Qiyamah, when everyone will be running away and worried about and concerned about themselves, people will be drowning in their sweat. That day will be severe. And on that day, they will be all be running to the Anbiya, and all the Anbiya will say that, myself, Nafsi, Nafsi. They will ask to intercede by Allah. Everyone will run to each Nabi, Nabi Adam, Nabi Ibrahim, Nabi Musa, Nabi Isa. And they will come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will say, ana laha, I am created for this. I was created for this. I was created to intercede on your behalf. But there will be those special people that will be close to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on that day. أَقْرَبُكُمْ مِنِّي مَنْزِلًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. On that day, the one who is most closest to me on that day, what did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? The one who is most beautiful? The one who is most handsome? The one who has the most money? No! The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not say this. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَحْسَنُهُمْ خُلُقًا. The one who has the most beautiful character, the one who interacts the most beautiful with people, with their family, with their wives, with their children, with their colleagues, with their community, with their neighbors. That person will be the most closest to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of Qiyamah. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the closest of our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of our good character, that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us to be of those that will be closest to Him on that day when everyone is seeking for intercession. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of our good character, because we display this good character of the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, may it be that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam intercedes on our behalf, and that we in this dunya embody his good character. Salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.